Okay, good day everyone. My name is Attorney Marlon B. Raquel from Olivares College, Paraniaque City in the Philippines. That's part of Metro Manila. I'd like to thank the organizer for giving me an opportunity to present my research paper entitled The Influence of Entrepreneurship on Micro, Small, and Medium Enterprises, MSME Success in Montiparlas, Tapat, Inputs to a Proposed Entrepreneurial Success Model during the International Conference on Interdisciplinary Business, Economics, Management, and Social Studies, today, September 21, 2024, in Jakarta, Indonesia, which is organized by the Institute for Educational Research and Development. The contribution of micro, small, and medium enterprises is widely recognized in the overall economic development of a nation. Within the unique context of Montiparlas Tapat, the interplay between entrepreneurship and MSME success stands as a compelling area of inquiry. This understanding the intricacies between entrepreneurial activity and MSME success are of paramount importance. Now, Montiparlas Tapat is composed of four cities and one municipality in Metro Manila, Philippines. Now, this study analyzed the influence of the determinants of entrepreneurship on the entrepreneurial success of MSMEs in Montiparlas Tapat. Specifically, it sought answers to the following questions: what is the demographic profile of the respondents in terms of age, sex, educational attainment, and civil status? Second, what is the business profile of micro, small, and medium enterprises in terms of business location, MSME classification, number of employees, asset size, industry classification, and number of years in operation? What is the level of entrepreneurial activity of micro, small, and medium enterprises in Montiparlas Tapat in terms of access to entrepreneurial finance, government policy, government entrepreneurship programs, entrepreneurship education at school, research and development transfers, commercial and professional infrastructure, the ease of entry, physical infrastructure, and social and cultural norms? The fourth statement of the problem is there a significant difference on the level of entrepreneurial activity of MSMEs when grouped according to business profile? And number five, what is the level of entrepreneurial success of micro, small, and medium enterprises in Montiparlas Tapat in terms of company performance, workplace relations, community impact, personal financial rewards, and personal fulfillment? Number six, is there a significant difference on the level of entrepreneurial success of MSMEs when grouped according to business profile? Is there a significant relationship between the level of entrepreneurial activity and the level of entrepreneurial success of micro, small, and medium enterprises in Montiparlas Tapat? And lastly, based on the results of the study, what entrepreneurial success model can be proposed? Now, for the research methodology, I have utilized the quantitative correlational research design. And the sampling technique that was used is cluster random sampling. The participants are the business owners of different micro, small, and medium enterprises. Through the researcher made survey questionnaire, so the data gathered were analyzed. Frequency and percentage distributions, weighted means, verbal interpretations and rankings, analysis of variance and post hoc tests, and person correlations coefficients were utilized. So as to the results and discussion, so for the statement of the problem number one, the study includes 744 business owners of MSMEs located in Muntinlupa City, Paranaque City, Las Piñas City, Taguig City, and Pateros, Metro Manila. Majority of the business owners belong to 18 to 27 age bracket, females, college graduates, and single. Now, based on the findings of the study, nowadays, more females than males engage in businesses. Furthermore, more young people are starting to start micro-businesses by which they would be able to earn income, and many of them are college graduates. The recommendation for this particular finding is that these businesses may create initiatives and tailored assistance programs with the goal of empowering women business owners, make resources and support services easier for young people who want to start their own businesses. So despite of the problems that they might encounter, they need to ensure that the young people will be given opportunities to start their business. Now, the second of result of this study is that in terms of business profile, majority of the businesses are small enterprises located in Muntinlupa City, have 10 to 99 employees. In terms of asset size, they have about 3 million pesos and are engaged in other service activities and have been operating for less than 5 years. So the MSMEs will continue to flourish in number of establishments as shown in the number of businesses as compared to large enterprises. This is primarily due to lesser capital requirements, and it is easier to establish MSMEs than large businesses. For the recommendation, MSMEs, which compose of about 98% of all businesses in the country, should be provided with seminars and technical workshops that would help them in their businesses, not to improve their products and services. So support for micro and small and medium enterprises is very crucial. The third finding is that access to entrepreneurial finance, government entrepreneurship programs, entrepreneurship education at school, research and development transfers, commercial and professional infrastructure, the ease of entry, physical infrastructure, and social and cultural norms are moderately implemented. So all the 9 predictors used in the study are significant in order to achieve the success of businesses, and particularly the access to entrepreneurial finance, which are important sources of business financing options to new and growing firms. So for the recommendation, the researcher would want to recommend that private financing businesses should be enhanced for MSMEs, okay, and that these businesses should create a multidimensional strategy that takes into account the difficulties that they normally encounter, because especially for the small businesses and micro businesses, they have difficulty in applying for loan in banks because of some collateral and other requirements imposed upon them. So for the fourth finding, the ANOVA or the analysis of variance show that a statistically significant difference are observed in entrepreneurial activity among the different locations in MSMEs, where higher levels of entrepreneurial activities are observed in Muntinlupa City, Taguig City, and Parañaque City than in Las Piñas City. So small and medium enterprises have significantly higher levels of entrepreneurial activity than micro enterprises. Likewise, higher levels of entrepreneurial activities are observed in businesses with 10 to 99 employees than in business with 1 to 9 employees, and in businesses which have been operating between 5 to 10 years than with less than 5 years of business operations. So the observed difference of entrepreneurial activity by location means that each city differs in the implementation of their business activities. So the small and medium enterprises, due to their relatively larger resources than micro enterprises, exhibit higher levels of activity. Coping with government bureaucracy, regulations, and licensing requirements is an important dimension of entrepreneurial activity. So for the recommendations, MSMEs and LGUs, or the local government units with lower levels of entrepreneurial activities, should benchmark with businesses with higher levels of entrepreneurial activities. So micro-enterprises should be provided with opportunities in order for them to thrive and grow. Now, for the fifth statement of the problem, the main finding here is that the company performance, workplace relations, and personal financial rewards are moderately achieved. So this is based on the responses of the business owners. Community impact and personal fulfillment are highly achieved. So the findings of this study underscore the importance of implementing a holistic approach in ensuring the success of businesses. It also means that entrepreneurial activities should not only be directed towards company performance, workplace relations, and personal financial rewards, but also to how the impact of the businesses to the community and performance fulfillment could be achieved. So to increase the level of the success of these businesses, sufficient equity funding, debt funding, funding from informal investors, venture capitalists, and private lenders must be enhanced, no, for so that they would be able to give financial support to small and micro businesses. Another important finding in this particular study is that the ANOVA results also show that the level of entrepreneurial success is statistically significant when grouped according to different location. So the level of entrepreneurial success varies depending on the characteristics of micro, small, and medium enterprises. So this suggests that each of these business classifications has unique characteristics that must be considered when implementing programs and policies. So in other words, there is no one-size-fits-all formula that would ensure success of entrepreneurial activities. So support initiatives for these businesses must be targeted and specific based on location, the type of the business, the number of employees, and the years of operation to address the disparities observed. For the statement of the problem number 7, the correlations results show that there is a significant relationship between entrepreneurial activity and entrepreneurial success. As entrepreneurial activity increases, the level of entrepreneurial success also increases. The relationship between the two variables are moderate. So I tested it also using the regression analysis. And this particular significant relationship show the pivotal role of entrepreneurship in ensuring success of MSMEs. When the entrepreneurs combine the resources, they create opportunities not just for themselves, but for the economic development of their respective localities and the nation in general. So it underscores the significance of supporting entrepreneurs in their endeavors as agents of progress in the MSME sector. So for the recommendation, the researcher recommends that the targeted specific strategies are recommended. So the entrepreneurship training programs that would imbue the importance of having an entrepreneurial mindset and skills must be implemented. So this is the output of the study, which is the entrepreneurial success model. So based on the findings, I designed an infographic material depicting the entrepreneurial success model, where 9 success indicators are indicated that would help the micro, small, and medium enterprises achieve success. So the 9 indicators are included in this particular infographic materials. So the rationale behind this proposed ESM for MSMEs is essential for creating a an environment that is supportive of MSMEs. So it considers government policy, entrepreneurship programs, education, research and development transfers, infrastructure, ease of entry, and social and cultural norms. It necessitates a thorough comprehension of the elements that lead to success in the complex and demanding world of entrepreneurship. In the cutthroat business world of today, entrepreneurs can improve their chances of success by combining these essential elements into a holistic model. Furthermore, this model is a useful framework for aspiring business owners who would want to advance their experience and expertise. So how would each objective be achieved? So 1, encourage access to entrepreneurial finance. 2, encourage the development of favorable government policies. 3, strengthen government entrepreneurship programs. And 4, integrate entrepreneurship education in school curricula. Then facilitate research and development transfer. Build commercial and professional infrastructure. Encourage ease of entry, invest in physical infrastructure, cultivate social and cultural norms, and lastly, ensure sustainability and inclusivity. So that would be all. Thank you so much once again for giving me an opportunity to present my research paper at the International Conference on Interdisciplinary Business, Economics, Management, and Social Sciences, organized by the Institute for Educational Research and Development in Jakarta, Indonesia, today, September 21, 2024. Thank you very much. Marami pong salamat.